Hello, everybody. Andrea Majewski here with Dentalelle Tutoring. So let's talk about how to answer those tough interview type questions, or even how to answer the basic interview questions that you will probably be asked when you are being interviewed for either the dental hygiene or the dental assisting position. So this kind of goes for all dental professionals. I have sat in on many of them, and I'm still amazed at how some people just don't know. Or I find the things that come out of their mouth is just kind of like, oh, why did you just say that? You know, we know you're nervous, but just certain things that I want to talk to you guys about so you can have a good head start and you don't have to be as nervous. I wish I had YouTube when I first started in the dental profession, because this would have been so nice to kind of teach me too, because I just kind of went in there, didn't know what I was doing. But basically, you do have to sell yourself. That's basically what you have to do. You have to make yourself sound amazing. But let me go through some things that might make your resume not look so good and how you can overcome that. Okay, so typically, on a resume, if you don't have any dental experience, that doesn't look good, but you have to start somewhere, right? So this is how you can make yourself sound amazing. So if they're kind of going through the resume and they go, well, you haven't worked in a dental office before, you know, we're really looking for somebody with experience. You can say, you know, let me think about that. You know, like I know what I would say. So, and what I would be expecting to hear. So you can say something like, I have a lot of clinical knowledge in school. You know, we have to see 30, 40 patients. And I feel like I have a good, you know, knowledge base to get started. And I'm so excited to learn. You know, you can show me anything. I am easily adaptable because I have nothing to compare it to. It's not like I've been working in an office for 30 years and I'm set in my ways. Well, not at all, because I actually haven't worked in a dental office before. You can also say, for my co-op, we did our co-op for a month or 2 months, however long it was, and I did learn a lot, and they had all nice things to say about me, so I take that as a good sign, and I did learn a lot there. You know, so you see how I make it sound like I'm a real person, you know, like, yeah, I totally understand, but I am easily adaptable. You know, that's what they want to hear, because let me tell you, I would prefer to hire somebody younger and newer than somebody with 30 years experience that comes in and goes, I've never worked with a computer before. I am used to paper charting. I like to do things my own way. These are the instruments that I have to have. You know, that drives me crazy. And I do find that those with more experience like me, we are set in our ways a little bit more. Whoops, sorry guys, my alarm. And we know what we want. So if we're not used to something, we might be kind of more hesitant, but you can show them that you are an open book. You know, you want to learn as much as possible. They love that. Trust me. Another thing that they might say is, okay, well, how much do you want to get paid? That's always the tricky question, right? I always say, well, that price is negotiable, but I am asking for this amount. So where I live, it does depend on where you live. Where I live, it's totally normal for a new grad to ask for $30 per hour. Don't ask for less than $30 per hour. But again, this is where I live, so around Kitchener, Ontario. And we say to not ask for less than $30 per hour because we need hygienists. We have experienced hygienists making $45 per hour. And yes, you might be saying, well, why can't I make closer to $45 per hour then? You just can't, because new hygienists, we need to teach you guys so much. You know, it's just, you have to start somewhere, right? If you go in there as a new hygienist and say, well, I want to make $40 per hour. It's not that they won't pay you that, but they're thinking, okay, you must be quite the person to think that you're worth $40 per hour with no experience. So be completely reasonable, okay? You asking, again, depending on where you live, $30 per hour is totally okay. If they say to you, well, we were looking to pay $29 per hour, how does that sound to you? what are you going to say, right? You're thinking, well, that's pretty close. I would take that because I need the money. But what I want you to say is, you know what? I like everything that I've heard so far. So I will take $29 per hour if we can have a talk in 3 months' time. And if you guys like me and like what I'm doing, then I would like to make $30 per hour after 3 months. I think that sounds pretty good, right? Right? Or you can negotiate other things too. Like you could say, well, am I guaranteed 25 hours per week? Or am I guaranteed 40 hours per week? So all of that is a good idea. But just a quick thing to mention though, if you do settle on the, okay, I'll take the 29 per hour, but in 3 months, once you can see that I'm good and that you like me, I want to talk about making $30 per hour, and I want that to actually start like 3 months from now. So it's March the 25th. So March, April, May, June. So June 25th, I want to be making $30 per hour. You will have to go to the dentist and say, okay, it's been 3 months. Can we have a talk? Like, how am I doing? They will not come to you. They will not come to you after 3 months and say, hey, can I talk to you? So I think I would like to give you the $30 per hour now. They won't. You need to go to them. So if you're going to negotiate something like that, make sure you feel comfortable enough to go to them. Or say, you know what, I would like the $30 per hour. I hope that's okay with you. That's just the lowest that I can go. You know, you can say something like that too. That's totally up to you. But that's what I would do if I was in your situation, is I would say, okay, I'll take the 29, but in 3 months, if you guys like me, then I would like to make the $30 per hour. So that's a very, very common question. So that is something that you should do. Other than that, those are kind of the trickier questions, right? They might say something to you like, well, why do you feel that you would be a good fit for our office? So you might be kind of repeating yourself a little bit here. So you could say something like, well, from what I see, like you have an amazing office. I just get a good feel for the place. You know, everybody seems happy. Like everybody seems to be in a good mood. I like that. Patients seem happy so far, you know, from what I can see from when I walked in. Plus, you know, you could say something like, plus I just moved here. I'm looking for my second home. You know, I want to find like a work family where I am here all the time. You know, like that's what I want. I want to work hard, and I want to show you guys that I can work hard and that I would be an amazing fit for this office. You know, so they might ask you something like that, right? And that sounds pretty good. You know, like obviously change it to make it sound like you. You could say, well, I've had my eye on your office actually for a long time, because when you first built the office, you know, it just looked so amazing. I was still in school at the time, but I had always kind of watched the office, and I knew that one day I wanted to work there. And then as soon as I walked in, I thought, wow, this is such a nice office, and I just have a good feeling, you know, overall. So make it sound like you, obviously. Like, don't just take my answers if they don't make any sense, right? But that is something that they like to hear. What else? Darn, I can't think of anything else, you guys. Those are kind of the main questions that we usually ask. Sometimes we might ask you if you're a dental hygienist being interviewed. We might say something like, how do you feel about like helping out assistants if they need help? How do you feel of working at the front desk? So they might ask you something like that, but that's all up to you. Like I know for me, I would say, well, I don't mind helping out assistants. Like absolutely. I am used to doing that anyway, but I do prefer to not work at the front because I like to focus on my clinical skills at this time. You know, I don't know, something like that. But when I first started as a dental hygienist, I actually worked at the front on Mondays because I was still a receptionist. So, but I didn't mind at the time because I wanted the extra hours. You would get paid less as a receptionist. So, but just keep that in mind. They might want you to do many things, but if that's the case, then you should definitely ask for that $30 per hour, because you know that they're going to pay less if you're working at the front, and just make sure that you're working as a hygienist more. So just something to keep in mind. If that's something you don't want to do, that's okay, but just make sure to say it in a way like, well, at this time, I would like to focus on my clinical skills as a hygienist. I am more than happy to help out, but I want to keep my hours as hygiene hours. So does that sound nice? I think that sounds pretty good. But if you guys are thinking of any other tough questions, be sure to comment below, because I'm sure I'm forgetting some. But those are the main ones that nobody ever talks about. So I wanted to talk about it here. So thank you guys for watching, and make sure to hit subscribe if you haven't yet, because I do upload some new videos every week. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Hopefully this was helpful.